Rust. So if I go to the developer center and scroll down to Rust on AWS, I get here AWS SDK for Rust in AWS Lambda. And oh, we originally developer preview. Okay, do not use it in production. It is subject to breaking changes. Okay. It turns out, by the way, so there is an example of essentially doing everything you sell, everything yourself. But it turns out that there is an open source project which makes a lot of this pretty easy, called Cargo Lambda. And Cargo Lambda is an independent project. I happen to know that David here, Calavera, is actually an AWS staffer. So it's not super independent as far as open source packages go, but it's extremely good. And to get started, we use pip3. And you might be wondering why it is that you would want to use a Python installer to get going with a Rust project. And I suppose that's probably because pip is a little bit more flexible with what it allows you to upload, I assume. I actually am not entirely sure. So if I copy and paste some text into Lambda, and then it's immediately giving, is this an HTTP function? Yes, it is. And I want to say I am going to use the HTTP API and I think we're okay. We've got a new project called New Lambda Project, which isn't the most exciting name. And if I, some code here is already provided by Cargo Lambda. I need to implement a function handler, which is looking for a parameter called name inside the query string. And then I've got a main thing here, which also includes a service function, which is invoking the function handler. And the main call, the main function takes a handler, which is a service function that wraps a function handler. So I've got three functions in one, which makes explaining things extremely complicated. Now, to get going or to test it, I can say Cargo Lambda watch. What this will do is build the code and then compile it. I find it's easier to run build manually just because it's a little bit more explicit about what's actually happening. You can see that Rust is bringing down 108 packages. It's drawing very heavily from the open source ecosystem, even though it is an AWS project. And there we go. Compiled in 30 seconds. If I run Cargo Lambda watch, it will watch the server will be invoked and it will detect any changes that are made. And if I create a new and where are we listening? We're listening on port 9000. You can see this, it seems like nothing is happening, but actually that's partially because we haven't actually invoked the correct syntax to get it right. We actually need to do a little bit more. And oh, that's not the where I wanted to be. That's interesting. To add some verbose, actually it's a permanent redirect, and so I also require the location follow, could not multiplex even if we wanted to. Okay, the L flag, by the way, adds the redirect. and it's waiting for a response, but cargo now cargo watch is actually compiling the code again. So my build step earlier didn't actually do what I wanted. It's been a while since I okay, hello world, this is an AWS Lambda HTTP request. If I can clear again, and then if I add name equals Tim. Hello Tim, this is an AWS Lambda HTTP request. I can remove verbose, and there we go. We get the response that we wanted. So that is as much as you need to do to get something running locally. If you follow the instructions and don't run build first, Lambda Watch will do what you want. To actually get it uploaded into AWS, it's actually relatively easy with Cargo Lambda. There's just a release step, build under release mode, and then we deploy it.